Dear all, welcome to the playlist of Basic Electrical Engineering. In this video, I'll be discussing the importance of series circuit, and we are going to solve some numerical examples related to series circuit. Now let's understand what do we mean by series circuit. The series circuit is nothing but two or more elements which are said to be connected in cascaded manner. If two or more elements are connected in cascaded manner or series fashion, the same current will be flowing through each and every element. One analogous example I would like to tell you. You can able to observe the bogies of train. Here you can able to observe how the bogies have been connected. Bogies have been connected in the cascaded or serial fashion. See, it will be the ending point of one bogie is connected to beginning point of another bogie. Similarly, ending point of another bogie is connected to beginning point of another bogie. It has been connected in cascaded or you can call serial fashion. When it comes to electrical circuit, the same current that will be flowing through each and every element. So for example, you can able to see there are three bulbs, 1, 2, and now it is not connected. Earlier it was connected. When it was connected, we can able to say that these three elements are in series, so that the same current, if it is connected with the battery, the same current will be flowing through each and every element. Immediately the bulb has been removed, what is going to happen? The supply will be removed. Supply will be cut out. Okay, supply will be removed. Here also the same condition. See, current will be passing from positive to negative. So both the bulbs are serial. So same current, current which is flowing through the lamp 1 is equal to current which is flowing to lamp 2. But the condition is the voltage across each and every lamp, that will be depending on the resistance value of the bulb. So let it be V1 and this will be V2. Okay, the voltage value, that will be different, but the same current will be flowing through each element. That is a specialty of series connection. Okay. And also the equal resistance value also very high if you connect it in series fashion. Let us continue the discussion. I hope you understood what is a series connection. And one practical example of a series connection also I have explained. And immediately, if you connect three bulbs in series, one bulb has been immediately removed. What is going to happen also I have shown you. Now you can able to see the supply will be cut out immediately. Let us consider one electric circuit. We are having the battery source and R1, R2, R3. These are the three resistors. Now we can able to say that R1, R2, R3, resistor 1, resistor 1, 2 and 3, all are connected in cascaded fashion or series fashion. Okay, it is also known as cascade. Cascade or you can call series. Both are same. Okay. Cascade or series. Same current is going to flow, but the voltage will be different. This may be V1. You can call it as V1. This must be V2. Okay. Then you can call the voltage across the resistor 3, that will be V3. Voltage will be different and the current will be same in case of series circuit. That is a valuable point which you need to remember. Hope you understood what is a series connection and what are the specialty and what are the peculiarities of voltage and current. Now I would like to tell you what about the total resistance in a series circuit. Let us consider a series circuit. We can able to say R1, R2, R3, all are connected in series. Now I already told you that the voltage across individual resistor, that varies the value of resistance. So we can able to say that R1, R2, R3 are not identical. So the voltage across R1 and voltage across R2, voltage across R3, that will be differed. So I have written as the total voltage is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Same thing I have written over there. Just for your understanding purpose, I am rewriting again. You know that according to Ohm's law, the voltage is directly proportional to current. Or else I can write voltage is equal to R into I. We already discussed in the previous session. To get the videos of previous session, you can able to click on the I button. So you'll be getting entire information about the previous video. So let me replace with IR. Instead of V, I'll be writing IR. So same current is flowing. So let me write I into R. I into R. So this will be the total resistance. See, V is equal to I into R, where R is the total resistance. Let me call it as R equivalent, R subscript EQ. Then what about V1? How to write? According to Ohm's law, V1 is equal to I into R1 plus V2 means I into R2. It is also very clear. And V3 means I into R3. Now what we will do is I is a common factor because same current is flowing now. So I is a common factor. So let me take the I in a outside a common factor. So I into R1 plus then R2 plus R3. Okay, you can close the bracket. Here you can able to see in the LHS side there is one current I. In the RHS side also same current is flowing. So LHS and RHS same term will be cancelled. So what are the term which are remaining? So I'll be writing R or R total. R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, if the values of R all are equal, then we can able to say R plus R plus R3 R. If n number of resistors are connected, you can write n into R. In series circuit, the resistance of the value of entire equal resistance will be very much high. That's a specialty. That point also I would like to inform you. I think you know how to find out the total resistance in a series circuit. By using Ohm's law, we can able to compute. Just a derived. Okay, this expression you can remember. Okay, so this is regarding the equal resistance of series circuit. You can able to observe the CFL lamps are connected in serial fashion. In this regards, the same current is flowing through each and every lamp, but the voltage will be different. This may be V1. Okay, the voltage across the CFL lamp 2, that will be V2, because it will be depending on the resistance of the lamp. This must be V3. Okay, voltage is getting divided. So total voltage will be V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay, therefore we can able to say that resistance will be high in case of series circuit. Okay, in summary, the equal current which will be flowing through the entire circuit, suppose the voltage drop, that will be depending on the value of resistance. Okay, and also if there are n identical resistance, each are having R connected in series, the equal resistance will be n into R. So we can able to make a common formula, R equivalent is equal to n into R. This formula you need to remember. So this is the formula for equal resistance when n number of resistance are connected in series. So RSN is equal to n into R. If the number of resistance are more, the equal resistance will be increased. That point also you have to remember. Now I would like to show you one example, simple example I would like to show you. First, let us consider the circuit. So total voltage is equal to 9 volt. Okay, the resistance value is equal to 3 kilo ohm, then 10 kilo ohm, and 5 kilo ohm. All are connected in series. So first, you are supposed to calculate what is the total current which will be delivering from the source. You need to calculate the total current which is flowing through the circuit. First, in the foremost, I need to calculate the R equivalent. R equivalent need to be calculated. How to calculate R equivalent? R1 plus R2 plus R3. Since the circuit in series, I can able to write it as R1 plus R2 plus R3. Okay, same thing I have written over there. I think it is clear. So R1 is equal to 3, R2 is equal to 10K, R3 is equal to 5K. You can add 3 plus 10 plus 5. How much it is? It will be 18 kilo ohm. If you want, you can convert into ohm. That means 18 into 10 to the power 3. I need to compute the value of current. According to Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. V is equal to IR. So from this expression, you can able to separate the value of I. I is nothing but voltage upon resistance. So what is the value of voltage? 9 volt. 9 volt divided by what is the value of resistance? 18 kilo ohm. If you want, you can convert into SI unit. 18 into 10 to the power 3. Okay. 9 divided by 18 means 0.5. I have what? The value of 9 by 18 is equal to 0.5. 10 to the power 3 will come into numerator. So it becomes 10 to the power minus 3. 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. Therefore, 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3 can be written as, it is very simple, 0.5 milliampere. 0.5 milliampere. So 1 ampere is equal to 1000 milliampere. Okay, 1000 milliampere. Same concept I will be applying here. So I am getting the answer as 0.5 milliampere. So likewise, you need to solve different number of problems. This is only a simple example. In the next session, I'll be solving numerical examples on series circuit, parallel circuit, and series parallel circuit. In the next session, anyway, I have to explain parallel circuit, afterwards series parallel circuit. So we'll be solving n number of problems. In this video, I have discussed about the specularities of series circuit and some typical examples of series circuit. Current will be same, but the voltage will be different. That's the main summary. As the number of resistance will be increased, the value of equivalent resistance also will be getting increased. Okay. So in household application, we are not recommending series connection, because if any of the lamp or any of the device spoil, the entire supply will be cut out. So series circuit is not suitable for household application. In the coming session, I am going to discuss about parallel connection. Finally, thank you for watching this video.